Now, my students, if you remember, last time we talked about the verbs and we said we have verbs in present and verbs in the past. So, rule number one, if we are talking about something in present it means you do it every day. So, the sentence must start with subject, then verb one. Now, subject, then verb one. Now, look at the following question. What do you do every day? Here, from this question, you know that it's about something in present because the verb do is in present. And also, we use the key word every day. Every day we use it when we are talking about something in present. Now, look at the answers. I go to school. Go is a verb in present. We call it also verb one. I make a cake. Make also is a verb in present. I help my mother. Also, help is a verb in present. And the last answer is, I watch TV. Watch is a verb in present. Don't forget, you can use more than one keyword. Not every day, for example, you can use always, sometimes, usually. You can use every, for example, Friday, at the weekend. You can use these keywords to talk about something in present. Now, rule number two, if we are talking about something in the past, so the sentence starts with subject, then verb two. Verb two, it means a verb in the past. Also look at this question. What did you do yesterday? Here, the verb did is a verb in the past. It's the past of do. What did you do yesterday? And also here, we used the key word yesterday. It means this thing happened and finished in the past. Also now, please look at the answers. Number one, I went to school. Went is a verb in the past. I made a cake. Made also is a verb in the past. Helped, I helped my mother. Helped is a verb also in the past. And the last example is, I watched TV. Watched is a verb also in the past. But please pay attention that some verbs, look at go, when we turn it into past, it becomes went. So here you can notice that these two words are not similar to each other. Look at the word make. Also, we changed some letters in it. But look at the example help. When we changed it into past, only we added ed, ed, help in present, in the past, helped. Look at watch, watch in the past, it becomes watched. We added ed only. So some words like go or make, when we change them into past, we change the letters. But other words like help and watch, when we change them into past, we only added ed. Thank you. Now, my students, please look at the words in the box and read them. Donkeys, ducks, sheep, cows, dogs, horses, and hens. Then, look at the pictures of the animals and tell me the animals you can see in these pictures. Number one, yes, dogs. Number two, cows. Very good. Number three, donkeys. Excellent. Number four, horses. Number five, ducks. Number six, yes, sheep. And the last one, number seven, hens. Don't forget that the word sheep in singular or in plural is the same. So we say, I can see one sheep, or I can see two sheep. We don't add S to it. Now please read the sentences below, then rearrange the letters to write correct words in the spaces, then complete the boxes with the numbers of the pictures above. Take 3 minutes to do it. Well done. Now, let's read and check your answers. Number one, I helped my uncle with the sheep and the horses. Very good. Now, which picture refers to the sentence? The first one is number six. Very good. The second one is number four. Excellent. Horses. Now, sentence B. I played with the hens. Very good. And the ducks. Excellent. Now tell me the pictures that refer to this sentence. The first one, number seven. Excellent. Hens. The second one, number five, ducks. Very good. Now, sentence C. We watched the space. Donkeys, very good. And the cows, very good. Now, which pictures refer to this sentence? The first one, number three, very good. And the second one, number two, yes, excellent. Now, the last sentence, there aren't what? Dogs, very good. And the picture is number one. Excellent. Well done. Now, my students, write in your copybook. Let me read for you the two sentences in front of you. I played with the horses. I helped with the hens. Now, your duty is to copy these two sentences in your copy book within 4 lines. Very good.
Thank you for watching this video. I hope you understood everything. Please study well. See you.